Next is arithmetic instructions. That is, they are simple instructions: addition, subtraction, increment, decrement, multiply, and divide. Let us see each one of them. So add destination comma source. The name itself tells you that the data of the source and the destination will be added, and the sum will be stored in the destination. So if 2000 and 5000 are the, adding 2000 and 5000, the data becomes 7000 and stored in AX register. Same way, if we use ADC destination comma source, with destination plus source, carry bit is also added. So in this example, that is 2000, 5000 and carry is bit 1. So if 2000, 5000, that is 7000, 7001 will be stored in the AX register. Next is increment source. Basically, what is the, any register or any memory location which is being pointed. In the example, you can see that I increment AX, or you can have a square bracket 5000. Basically, it will do is that it will go to that data. If it is square bracket 5000, it will go to the memory. If it is increment AX, it will go see the data inside AX register and increment the value of AX register by 1. So that will be changed to 7001 after the execution of instruction. Multiply operand is a very powerful operand. Basically what it does is that it will multiply. One of the operands should be in accumulator, and one of the operands is given along with the instructions. So in this example, mul bh, what is going to happen is that mul bh of bx register, that is the higher byte, will be multiplied by al. As it is bh, it is an 8-bit register, it will be multiplied with an 8-bit accumulator, and then the result will be 8-bit, 16-bit, that will be stored in the AX register, that is 0008. So 8-bit multiplication will give you a 16-bit result. Same way, 16-bit multiplication will give you a 32-bit result. Okay. And for storing a 32-bit result, definitely AX register is not enough. So DX register is also used to help accommodate 32-bit number inside the 8086. Reflection quiz, basically what we want to do is that you have studied the AND operator. Now you have to find an operator which will help you to set certain data without affecting the other bits. So you have to recall about all the knowledges of digital circuits you had studied, and you have to find an operator which will help you to do this. So pause for a while and think about this question, write down the answer in the journal, and then you can play it again. Okay, let us see the answer. Basically, OR operator is the one which will be the which will help us to do this. It will set certain bits which you want to set, and basically not affect any other bit which it is going to get added with. So in this example, you see that AX has 2000 and that will be ORed with 0008, and so here we have an AX register that has 2000 and 008, which will be ORed, and then your answer will become 2008. So shift left instruction performs a logical left shift on the destination operand, filling the lowest bit with zeros. Here you can see your 8-bit register and the carry flag at the left, and then what will happen is that each bit will transfer the data to the next bit on the left, and the MSB of the register will transfer the data to the carry flag. So in this regard, we have the LSB, which is the empty, but the LSB is filled with a zero value at every shift. So you have move BL5 comma 5D. What is going to happen is that 5 value is getting copied to BL register, and when SHL BL comma 1, then it means that the data is going to shift by 1 bit. This data of BL is going to shift by 1 bit, and the value will become 0A. In branch instruction, basically you are going to execute a kind of a subroutine program. You are going to break the sequence of your main program and go to a different memory location, execute the new program, and then if you have finished with that, you come back to the main program. So call instruction will help you to jump to a different location, execute that. And to return from the subroutine program, you need the instruction RET. So this RET instruction will help you to come back to your main program. Jump is also one of the methods to jump to a certain label, which will help you to call and jump are unconditional, but jump also has conditional jump instruction, which we'll see in the future. So this is all the instructions of jump instructions. I urge you to go through all of them. They are very essential, especially jump if carry, jump if zero, are very essential for all the programmings we are going to do in the subsequent chapters. So I will urge you to go through all these jump conditional jumps which are there. For just an example, I can take jump JC, that is jump if carry. If a carry bit is 1, you should jump to a location. So JC space label. Label is basically the location where the if the condition is satisfied, the instruction pointer will jump to that location.